This week on Crunch Week, Uber raises, the IPO market cools, and Spotify's year in review. Hello, welcome to Crunch Week. I'm Kyle Russell, and I'm joined this week by
Alex Wilhelm
and Sarah Burr.
Okay, guys, so this week, biggest news, I think, is probably Uber raised a shit ton of money again.
Yeah, I feel like we've done this about four times now. I'm a little depressed because after the media firestorm of them being complete shitheads kind of came to pass, they raised another $1.2 billion and then wrote this faux contrition blog post like, yes, we know our culture must, you know, improve, blah, blah. By the way, we're now worth $40 billion, middle fingers up. For context, by the way, that's roughly one Twitter and three Groupons. Evaluation combined.
It's also approximately two Teslas, I think. A little bit less than two Teslas.
And about one-fourth of an Amazon. So,
man.
I don't know if that's at all useful to anyone, but that's roughly what it is. I mean, were you surprised by this?
No.
No.
No, everyone knew that was coming. They can, I mean,
the pace surprised me. The fact that like Uber at some point would be valued $40 billion, no surprise.
Right.
I feel like it's just rapidly growing, expanding into new markets. But to quickly go from 17 to $40 billion, post-cash.
Well, it was 18.2 post, and then it was around 40 the second time. So it's roughly 2x.
And it doesn't matter any kind of negative news they had. It doesn't even matter.
You know what kills negative news? Fucking revenue growth.
Yeah.
And can't stop the up to the right.
Right.
And they're just saying, you know, we raised another billion, and they even said how they're going to use it. We're going to use this to expand in the Asian Pacific market. We're going to go all up in having people with carts to all the way to having people in Mercedes driving around in, like, China. Like,
yeah.
They're doing a full court push.
So two years ago, I would not have understood that. I would have been like, that's kind of bullshit. Then I went to Shanghai and and got a small taste of the scale of Asia. Mm-hmm. And like, you have to actually go there and like be driven around and like look and go like, oh, right. There really are several billion people here. Mm-hmm. So I totally get it. And if they can actually nail that market, they have growth for what, 5-10 years ahead of them? I mean, it's going to be insane.
So
it won't be cheap, though.
One thing that was a little interesting was they didn't disclose where they were raising from this time. So if you were in earlier or if you're a new investor, you didn't get to like have bragging rights for the round. Why would they do that, do you think?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, it could be money that's more strategic, as opposed to, you know, venture capital type money. Maybe, you know, maybe the Chinese government. I'm not positing that. I'm not starting a rumor. No, but I feel like sometimes investors want to be more quiet. I mean, they're not all Jason Calacanis.
Okay, so kind of on the opposite end of the spectrum in terms of being quiet, IPOs this year have been pretty big, but they seem to have cooled recently.
Well, I mean, a little bit. I mean, we've all been watching this money move around at a phenomenal pace this year. But two IPOs priced this week, New Relic and Hortonworks, and they both priced their IPOs initially, at least, at less than $1 billion in valuation. And that's notable because, if I recall correctly, they both raised private money at either a billion or more before. Hmm. So they're being pretty conservative. I mean, so this can be one of two things. When Zendesk went public, it went very conservatively priced to start off with and then doubled in the public markets and everyone's very happy. It meant less cash raised for the company, but very good for the shareholders. In this case, you know, if you're worried about market chop or just general market dynamics that are not maybe conducive to a higher priced IPO like GoPro, then sure, you price a little lower, you go public, you get 20% pop day one, everyone calls it a success and you walk on. We'll see. But certainly at least we're seeing more pullback and this could be indicative of shifting trends in the larger tech market on the financial side. We'll see. But I'm very, very interested to see where these IPOs go when they finally come out.
So do you think this is a trend that will continue into early 2015? Or do you think maybe it's just sentiment right now?
Well, I want my rent to go down. So I'm going to go with, I really hope it's a trend that continues. I mean, when this bubble, such as it is, does pop a little bit.
Bubble or funding acceleration?
Well, you know, tomato, potato, whatever. I mean, call it what you will. I mean, it's an overinflated asset class that impacts technology. Fine. But certainly I think that there are some companies, maybe even Uber, that are in fact overpriced. People are now paying for next year's growth or next year's growth or next year's growth. And you can't really Burning Man your way to revenue. So for a lot of these firms, I'm sorry, that was for Sarah actually.
Okay, so
those Burning Man your way to revenue.
Look, I know a lot of VCs that go to Burning Man. I'm just saying. They are intense about it.
So on a lighter note, we're coming to the end of the year. Surprisingly quick. I can't believe it's like three weeks until Christmas and almost 2015. Yeah, like mind blown.
Yeah.
But
Kyle's almost 21. I mean, this is incredible.
I'm 21, everyone.
Oh, your defense, I'm actually 21.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay, guys. Back on the show. So at the end of the year, we get to do a lot of fun stuff, you know, rounding up what happened. And you had the fun idea to talk about Spotify's year in review. So
yeah.
Can you explain to those who aren't familiar with Spotify or, you know, music streaming services and this has been a thing for a while, but mm-hmm. a lot of people probably haven't seen this yet. So what is it?
Spotify did this last year, and they did it again this year to kind of show you what you've been listening to throughout the year and how you've been listening and where. Mm-hmm. Most people, a good majority of people, seem to favor Pharrell's Happy. They were, that was really popular, or Frozen's Let It Go. Was a very popular song, so if you've been listening to that over and over and over
just
again,
just mentioning play it back in your head again. Thank you.
Yeah,
don't. It's kind of like, the rest of the day.
It's not a mix of Happy and Let It Go, kind of playing at the same time in my head. It's
there's like, probably it's like a mix of that on YouTube that you could find.
I thought it was really interesting how much people were listening to and where they were listening to it, and then it also had this little globe thing you could spin around the world to see what the most popular songs were around the world, which was kind of interesting.
What was your top artist?
My top artist?
Yeah.
My top artist was Tokyo Police Club, I think.
Oh, my God.
Or that was one of them. That was one of them.
Do you hang out in the Mission a lot?
No, I know. It's. I do like a lot of indie bands. Like, I like this dreamy indie type pop that most people have never heard of, like Bare Hands.
Most people have never heard of. Kyle, have you heard of Bare Hands?
I have.
Oh, well, there you go. So everyone's heard about it because all three of us here. Wait, is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, they're not Katy Perry's Dark Horse. They're not Pharrell's Happy.
Okay.
They're,
yeah. So I think the interesting number to look at is total number of minutes listened. I don't have this fact because I jump around between streaming services a lot.
Alex, how many minutes have you listened to?
108,068.
That's disgusting.
I'm sorry. I like
you
music.
You Spotify.
Look, okay, I have said for a long ass time mm-hmm. that Spotify is the best $10 I spend every month. Like, mm-hmm. like I would, if they were like, it's $50
but
a month
how are
now.
You, when are you, you're listening mostly at your desk, right?
Basically, whenever I wake up and I'm not...
Everybody, he has stolen my headphones and listens nonstop.
And all you hear is metal in like this one section of the TC office.
All right. Listen, first off, it's not all metal.
I'll be like, Alex.
There's a lot of death rap there as well.
Alex.
Look.
Check out your headphones.
If everyone doesn't know, if you haven't been to the TechCrunch office, there's a lot of really funny people there, and they're often doing really funny things.
Yes,
and if you,
you
want
to
actually
out.
Focus, you have to zone out. So I put on a little Slayer. Well, Slipknot.
Yeah, I put on Trent Reznor, so I can't
right.
really.
Right, little Nine Inch Nails. It's good, and then you get in the zone. You feel your vibe like yeah. Blog post.
Whoa, not again.
And then everyone's like, hey, and you're like, fuck that, still writing. And so it's very important, and that's why I'm on Spotify so much. But I will say again, they charge more money for that same access. Mm. I shell it out.
No, don't give them any. If you're watching.
I mean, take.
They're not watching. All right. Maybe
Daniel E.
How many minutes did you listen to?
Not as many as Alex. Like a quarter, like a fifth of it. I listened to 17,000 something on Spotify.
That's 16%.
I don't listen to just Spotify.
Which is 1/6, actually.
Right. I listen to Pandora. I listen to RDO. I listen to
iTunes.
Listen
to RDO? I thought no one listened to RDO.
A lot of people on Twitter seem to.
A lot of people actually do listen to RDO.
So something that I noticed is...
I go back and forth.
Something that would eat into my number mm-hmm. had I tracked that throughout the year would be that I listen to a lot of podcasts in addition
yes,
to music.
Yes, that as well.
So,
yeah.
But when you guys talk about and like how much time you spend in it and mm-hmm. like the value you get from it, it makes me realize like I use the Overcast app to listen to podcasts, and I would pay a subscription fee to like considering I listen to probably like 20 hours of podcasts like every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
You know, just like depending on like when I actually do I front load all the podcasts sure. or you know listen to them throughout the time.
Did you listen but, to Serial?
I'm going to listen to it all at once over like a weekend.
I know. That's I said I was going to do that while we were traveling in Italy, and that never happened.
You were too busy eating pasta.
I'm listening to Tech Ones.
Yeah, that just didn't happen at all.
So I kind of wish that like Spotify would had a podcast offering where I could like, in addition to like having some of my subscription go to the like artists I listen to, the podcast producers I listen to, I want them to make money in addition to the like.
Would you
like,
listen to more podcasts if it wasn't Spotify, sir? Like if Serial was in Spotify right now, would you listen to it?
I don't know. It would mean less
jumping around.
Exactly. I would definitely, I think you're totally
yeah,
correct.
Yeah, because
setting up queues and playlists.
I mean, I listen to different services for different reasons. They all offer different things, so maybe. Mm.
And if, it was something if, like, especially if there was, like, chapters set up, like, through something like that,
ooh,
where it's, like,
yeah.
you can listen to, like, 4 minutes of podcast and then switch back to music, that would be my jam.
It'd be chill to have, like, 4 minutes of interspersing music, like, dun 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 and another news today.
It's like, on Radio Lab.
Exactly. Welcome to the BBC. It's like, I don't know. But I will say, I mean, I feel like that's an important thing because podcasts are notoriously unlucrative. They're awesome. But I mean, like, who's paying Siri?
No, I actually saw this one post by a former Apple developer who was thinking about making a podcast creation app. And he was saying, like, it seems to be that there's maybe, like, 100 to 500 actual podcast producers making money in the whole, like, Western world.
That's depressing.
But I think that's all we have for this week. So thanks for joining us.